Now the next one here that we have is the jungle machete. I don't mind this. I think this is quite great. This is actually my favorite out of all of the cold steel machetes that I've shown you today. I quite like this one. This one is a lot more sturdy in terms of the handle and the grip, and it's thicker from this part of the handle out along the blade, the body of the blade, the base of the body of the blade here is a lot thicker than your kukuri and so on. So it makes it a lot sturdier, okay? Because you've got a full tang, okay, only so far you can feel it. It doesn't go right down to the bottom of the handle, okay? So the thicker that is past the handle there, the sturdier that thing is. But it's got a lot more sort of, not just machete, but sword-like feel to it. So if you're gonna do some work with that, that's definitely a lot more comfortable for me. I've got a bigger hand, I've got a big grip, that fits in very, very well. A lot of my guys here in Japan said, fuck, that thing's heavy, you know, la la la, and I said, listen, you're a man, fucking stand up to piss, you know? It's, you want something that's gonna cut through trees? They're asking me if the other ones are gonna cut through trees. I said, no, they said bamboo trees or very small weeds or grass or something. And even then, you know, I would be concerned with that because you're likely to cut yourself by over swinging because you've got to put too much power into it because the thing's very very light, okay? This, with the natural weight that it carries, is gonna cut things a lot easier for you. So we're gonna show that, as I said, in the upcoming videos where we went out bush and we filmed all this stuff and did a lot of stuff with our GoPro, and that's awesome, awesome stuff. But first, again, you've got to know what you're looking for and sort of be aware of those things there too.